Live from the Cincinnati Gardens, it's NPSL Soccer tonight, the Canton Invaders and the Cincinnati Silverbacks. Good evening, everybody. I'm Mike Barrack alongside Dwight Burgess, and we are here at the Cincinnati Gardens as the Silverbacks, who look for their fifth win of the season against the Canton team with only three wins in 1995-96. So, Dwight, teams have struggled, but a very important game for both Cincinnati and Canton.
It really is, Mike, a big game for both teams. Canton has lost two of their last three in overtime. Cincinnati, meanwhile, appear to have built some momentum going into the holidays, winning three of four. They've dropped four of their last five. They need to get it turned around and quickly.
The Silverbacks have had some tough losses, but this season they've been bolstered by the addition of Sean Medved.
Sean has really shouldered the burden for Cincinnati this season, up to 62 points. He's in the top 15 in the league scoring, and he's taken on the captain's responsibilities in the long absence of George Fernandez.
And the Silverbacks are going to have to be wary of an offensive leader for Canton, Marcelo Carrera.
They call him the Maestro, and with good reason. He's fourth in the league in scoring right now. He leads the NPSL in shots attempted. He can get you on restarts. He is lethal from distance. In fact, the Silverbacks found that out opening night when we lost in Canton on a three-pointer in the last 2 minutes.
And, of course, our keys to the game here tonight, and the number one, is to stop that offensive leader for Canton.
Well, no doubt about it. Carrera will get you one place or the other. If you mark him tight, he'll lay it off to other players. You've got to contain him. Next thing for the Silverbacks, a solid start. Canton is minus 37 in the first quarter this season. Cincinnati must get off to an early lead. And then finally, hey, we need some introductions. The Silverbacks have been all over the place this week. They got to get refamiliarized and back into action.
Okay, we'll see if the Silverbacks can do it tonight against their cross-state rivals, the Canton Invaders. We'll have all the play-by-play in just a moment. Cincinnati and Canton on Sports Channel. Cincinnati Silverback Soccer is brought to you by Thriftway. Have a Thriftway day. Dial, America's number one antibacterial soap. Kick Citrus Soda, the new hardcore psycho nitro drink in a can. And by Bethesda Good Samaritan Hospitals.
Talking. Okay.
It's Mike.
Okay.
Right.
Is there a tagline for it? Just the Bethesda Good Samaritan injury and lineup report?
Yeah, I think it was.
What?
Shoot. It was a good open, I thought.
So the open never showed, huh? Unbelievable.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Cincinnati Gardens. Tonight, the Cincinnati Silverbacks and the Canton Invaders in NPSL action as the Silverbacks coming up under the big gorilla head here at the Cincinnati Gardens. I'm Mike Barrack alongside Dwight Burgess here at the Cincinnati Gardens. And Dwight, our first order of business is the injury and lineup report.
Yeah, we're pretty banged up, the Cincinnati Silverbacks. Mike Arujo is out with a hip problem. Mark Simpson went under the scope earlier in the week. Chuck Codd will have the same surgery next week, and he may be done for the year. They fear an ACL problem. So certainly that's going to hurt, particularly with forcing George Fernandez to come back, and he's not totally healthy himself yet. Jimmy Glenn, well, he's going to be in uniform. Sean Blakeman, as we mentioned, George Fernandez, Mark Thomas. All four of those guys are banged up, but with the problems the Silverbacks are having right now, Mike, they just can't afford not to have them on the field, so into the stripes they go and onto the turf.
Okay, and of course that is our Bethesda and Good Samaritan lineup and injury report, the Healthy Goals program of Good Samaritan and Bethesda Hospital. As you mentioned, a number of scratches for both teams, including the former Cincinnati Silverback, Chris Fowl, who's out for Canton.
Yeah, it's an interesting point. Chris Fowl is out. He's got some knee problems. But, you know, Chris King was traded to Chicago. He broke his nose in a collision with Zoran Karic. He's gone. Mike Goslin up in Buffalo broke his leg. Then Chris Fowl goes down with a knee injury. I don't know if that was foresight on the part of the Silverbacks or not.
Chris D'Amico will be the starter tonight for Canton. Only 2-11, a 19.2 points against average. And he's only gone 4-27 over his 3 years in the NPSL, so he's had some tough luck in goal. Chris D'Amico will be the starter for the Canton Invaders. And for Cincinnati, Carlos Pena, 2-12, but a very strong 13-point goals against or points against average, and that actually ranks him sixth in the NPSL, Dwight, despite his record of just 2 wins.
Yeah, who would think that you could have a team ranked in the top half dozen of the league and a goalkeeper in the top six and yet only have 4 wins? It's incredible, but that's the story.
Okay, Cincinnati and their home whites, an expansion team, the team that moved from Dayton, Ohio, the former Dayton Dynamo team, against the Canton Invaders. They've had a storied history. They're one of the charter members of the National Professional Soccer League and have actually had some tremendous teams, just not the last couple of years.
Well, no doubt about it. On the field, look for Canton, a fairly disorganized team, to take what's offered, but you don't know from one shift to the next exactly what's going to happen. Cincinnati's going to want to put some pressure on them, particularly in the back third, for some turnovers.
Okay, here we go as we're underway. Canton 3 wins and Cincinnati with 4 in their first 17 games of their young franchise history. And immediately D'Amico has possession in his own side and bangs it in a midfield. On the right side, it's Mossavant. On the left wing side is the Invaders. Wheel it free, Mossavant to the top of the arc, and then just drops it free. So the Invaders with possession quickly in front. They score, and it was Jim Hesch on a centering pass, and 33 seconds gone. A 2-point goal, and the Silverbacks down by a 2-0 count. Carlos Pena can't believe it was so quick.
Coming into play tonight, Mike, the Canton Invaders upside down in the first quarter, and yet we turn around and give it up. Wide open right in front of the goal. Blakeman left watching, and Hesch put it in. Good entry pass and simply too much room inside the box. You've got to stand him up, and he did his job, finished it.
Well, the great pass from Ledesma on to Hesch. The time, 33 seconds into the opening quarter, and Cincinnati finding themselves down by a 2-0 count. And however, they back the other way. Cincinnati trying to work it free, but here come the Canton Invaders again. So Canton with only 2 road wins and 3 overall have taken the early lead. And they're trouble at times. Here's Ledesma, now tries to work it free to the near side. It's Doug Swanson, tied up. And finally, Cincinnati cleared for their leading scorer, Medved, tied up. And then on the right side, it's Denzel Antonio, their player coach. Shoots! That's off the backboards and wide. Swanson now at the top of the box, tries to work it free. And already it's all Canton, believe it or not, with a minute 20 gone into the opening quarter. And the Silverbacks, Dwight, not having much of an opportunity. It's all Canton here in the first couple of minutes.
Yeah, no doubt. Gary Hindley said that he wanted to be aggressive into the final third of the field, but at the moment, the Silverbacks are scrambling defensively.
Here's Hesch now, tied up by the former St. Louis Ambush, Terry Brown, but his pass broken up by Carrera. Shoots, blocked off at the defense. Hesch now has scored that goal, tied up on the play. Finally, it's Big Sean Blakeman bumps it into the midfield area where Kevin Scott plays it for Canton. Early on, Paul Kahn drops it back for Powers on the left side. And we've played almost 2.5 minutes into the opening quarter. And Carlos Pena has a good arm, able to outlet a pass up the left side. And Cincinnati's trying to make it play for Alcala, and it's just cleared right back into the Canton end.
Cincinnati's going to have to build from the mid third, try and get some numbers, some organization, and go forward from there.
And then Vincent Bank just levels Carrera in the midfield, and a restart and an opportunity, and Carrera's their leader. Here's a pass on the left side and a shot going up high as Kevin Scott was hit on the play up into the crowd, and Cincinnati will take over down 2-0, and Carlos Pena will start it up for Cincinnati.
And the maestro showed you right there that if you give him too much space out top, he will fake the shot and lay it off to teammates. You've got to play him straight up.
Canton Invaders, an original team in this league, able to work it free up the left side. And again, it was Hesch for Ledesma on that scoring play for Canton earlier, and then D'Amico has possession. This is his third year in the league out of the University of Akron. The goalkeeper, D'Amico, tries to play it free, and then again, the Invaders work it free in front on the left wing side. And Keith Defini, the former Kansas City attack, drops it back for Ben Powers in the midfield. So the majority of the control in favor of the Canton Invaders. And a bouncing around to the top of the arc. It finally cleared to Carrera in tight as the veteran Carrera centers across for Powers. That's off the mark. Cincinnati having all kinds of problems getting it out. And finally, it's taken off the left wing side. And here comes Cincinnati. Provan is too well tied up, and finally it's blocked off at the defense. Cincinnati trailing 2-0, and here is the Blair Thomas now for Cincinnati. Mark Thomas, who's been very strong since his acquisition.
Yeah, he really has contributed, not only with points on the board, but he goes into the corners, he battles hard, he sets other folks up, a real quality addition.
Here's Scott Cannon, who's thrilled to be playing in this game because his parents are watching tonight. They didn't have to make the drive over here to Cincinnati from Evansville as they play it free on the far side with a 2-0 Canton lead. Good crowd here tonight, the Cincinnati Gardens, and then a player tied up into the midfield area, Ledesma, and Canton contentious to hold on.
Cincinnati looks a bit sluggish here early, Mike, but that's not totally unexpected. Five of the Silverback players were out of town this week in L.A. at the MLS Combine. Lyndon Hooper's not here at all. He's playing for the Canadian national team in the Gold Cup.
And here are the Silverbacks taking control, and Pena just slams it with his right foot all the way down. And then dropping it back for the Invaders is Swanson, then an immediate pass for Ledesma. Blakeman stays with him into the far corner, and finally it squirts for the leading scorer, Medved, with over 60 points this year, just bangs it into midfield. And the Invaders down the right side, Scott moving in. Scott against Brown, his shot, and Terry Brown stays with him, and right to Pena. Good defensive play, not really a good shot on goal, Dwight, for Canton.
Yeah, you want to funnel them into the corner, try and get your numbers there, set up in and around the box and defend. Much better that time for the Silverbacks.
And Fernandez, the Hawaiian native, on four championships in professional soccer, including one with Cleveland. The NPSL for Gary Henley, the Silverbacks head coach. And they drop it back for Terry Brown. He won a championship last season in St. Louis. Tries to work it free, and the pass for Jimmy Glenn off the mark, cleared, but not out. Glenn along the far boards, tied up, and finally a stop and a hi everybody, Mike Barrick. Mike Barrack alongside Dwight Burgess. Apologize for any technical difficulties. Hi everybody, Mike Barrack alongside Dwight Burgess from the Cincinnati Gardens. We've had a few technical difficulties here. The Invaders on a hash goal from Ledesma, 33 seconds. Dwight have a 2-0 lead. The bulk of the possession so far in favor of the Canton Invaders.
Yeah, Canton really doing a good job pressing forward. Some disorganization early in the back cost the Cincinnati Silverbacks, but over the last couple of minutes, they've seemed to reestablish themselves.
Here's a play now and another scoring play as Hesch earlier, and then it was dumped in front for Carrera, and it's a 4-0 Canton lead. Pena can't believe it.
Well, just did I get the words out of my mouth. The ball, it's a turnover in the back. Carrera gets free, plays a give and go off the boards to himself and knocks it home. And just like that, Mike, down 4-0, and Canton came into this match giving up 37 more points in the first quarter than they are scoring. One of the keys to tonight's game for the Silverbacks was getting out to an early lead, and the absolute worst possible thing under those circumstances has suddenly happened.
Well, the 31st goal of the year for Carrera, and a 4-0 lead in favor of Canton.
Gary Hindley's not too pleased about it, and we have a stop and a timeout having been called, and we'll take a look at that second goal and the total of 4 points for Canton in this opening quarter.
Well, you can see Fernandez actually had good position. The ball just poked away from between his legs. Carrera, as big goal scorers are wont to do, right spot, right time, and he finished it off.
Carrera, known as the Maestro, 5 7-point games last year. He's an Argentina native, 32 years of age, and Gary Hindley, who has had great success against Canton when he was in Cleveland, finds himself down 4-0.
Well, he's not going to be happy about the start this evening. He discussed with us in the pregame the need for Cincinnati to create some things, put some pressure at the attacking third, force some turnovers by Canton, but it's been absolutely the opposite thus far.
And Cincinnati, who have not really had much ball possession at the outset, but Sean Blakeman into midfield. Despite a Cincinnati record of 3-7 at home, they've been outscored only by one at 127-126 so far. Here's a play to the side of the goal and steered aside by D'Amico and then cleared for the Canton Invaders up the left side. Antonio, their player coach, the assists at 605. Carrera's 31st of the year. Hatch is 6th from Ledesma at 33 seconds, giving Canton this 4-0 lead. And the play on the far side, and Antonio drops it back for Chris D'Amico, the 24-year-old from Kansas City, Missouri. And cleared by Canton into midfield, and then knocked down is Massavant into the Cincinnati territory, watched by Provan. Brown is with him too, and a foul and a restart coming up in favor of Canton early on. An aggressive Invaders team.
And a much different Invaders team. They've made wholesale substitution as the 95-96 campaign has progressed, and it's showing some positive things on the field.
Doug Swanson will take it. NCAA championship out of UCLA, a shot going wide. Now it's another chance for Massavant, and then it deflects up high, up into the stands, and Carlos Pena, who looks for his third win of the season. He comes into the action 6th in the league in PAA at 13.4, will leave it for his own defense.
Well, in the first half of quarter number one, it's been fairly simple, Mike, and that has been 50-50 balls going to the visitors.
4-1, as mentioned, in favor of Canton as far as the shots are concerned, and despite just a 2-win season so far for Pena, he's ranked 6th in the league in points against. He's been brilliant. Here's play up the left side. Defini, the former Kansas City attack, drops it off into the corner. Carrera is too well tied up, and finally it bounces up the right side for Kahn. Cincinnati looking for their first point of the game, and a lead pass along the far side as Cincinnati wheel it free to the near side for Blakeman, but it's off the mark and cleared up the right side. And here is the forward Defini into the Cincinnati end. Shoots, that's off the backboard. They score on the rebound. Kevin Scott, I believe, and it's a 6-0 Canton lead on the second opportunity.
Cincinnati continues to be victimized in the back. They just can't get their marks. You can see it's on the right side. Solid entry pass, and right inside position. Scott flicks it up high, roofs it. You just can't give him inside space. Alcala overcommits, and then look, he's goal side of his mark and puts it home. From behind the net, you get a good angle. Alcala initially in good position, but he overcommitted to the tackle right there. And then Scott was able to slip in behind Provan. That's that.
And Cincinnati down by a 3-goal count and 6-0 in points. Scott scores it from Keith Defini, and a 6-0 Canton lead. This is not what the Silverbacks had envisioned. They look at this as a good opportunity for a victory, and they're going to have to battle back. Although points in this game can turn around in a hurry. And Nedved will go, their leading scorer, drops it back to Beck with that strong left foot. His shot blocked away at the defense, and then the player Nedved knocked down. Cincinnati will have a chance in the offensive end. They've had just the one good scoring chance in this game, and Nedved turns, shoots, and an arm save made by the goalkeeper, D'Amico. And Cincinnati wasted no time on that restart with a quick shot from Medved.
A restart opportunity, a good way for Cincinnati to get back in the game. A week ago against St. Louis, an NPSL record was set as the Ambush converted 6 restart goals against Canton.
And that's what the strategy, obviously, for Cincinnati earlier, as Medved immediately took that shot. Here's Medved again, tied up in a midfield, and slammed all the way down. Oh, Pena was out, able to make the save. It was Hesch who let it fly from midfield and steered aside by Cincinnati's goalkeeper. And boy, that was a dangerous one, Dwight, as he had a backpedal to get back into his goal box.
Well, Ledesma is a veteran of this league, only played 3 games thus far this season because of contract problems, but in the last 10 days, he's got 11 points.
Here's the play now into midfield, blocked off on the left wing side as the play now in a midfield, and Provan drops it back for Perry Brown. Brown, who played last season in St. Louis, plays with that knee brace, drops it out the right side for Fernandez. Left side for Alcala now for Cincinnati. Shoots with a left foot, and on top of it is D'Amico, and he leaves it for his own defense.
That may be the best strike from distance that Alcala has had all season long to this point. They really need him to add some scoring to his arsenal that includes weapon number one being lots of speed.
A newcomer signed to Cincinnati December 21st, and now Paul Kahn now shoots, and an arm save by the goalkeeper Pena. And then Alcala breaks out of there. Lead pass for Glenn. Down the left wing side, centers in front of the net, and falling on top is the goalkeeper D'Amico, and he hurls it up the right side. And now Canton back the other way. Defini now in, tied up beautifully by Glenn, and he drops it back for Pena. Good scoring plays on both sides of the field.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Glenn, good stuff to come all the way back from the head of the team to help in the corner.
And the play up the left wing side where Blakeman, the former Wichita wing, bangs it up the left side. Medved cruising in, stops, shoots, blocked off by Powers, and Blakeman plays at the yellow line. His left footed headed away. Man scramble, and finally it's taken by Kahn up the left side. 4.5 minutes left, first quarter, 6-0 Canton. The Silverbacks have been held off the scoreboard early. It was Hesch, Carrera, and Scott notching goals. A Canton team that have had a great history, but have fallen on hard times, Dwight, the last few years. But they are a team that has had great success. Canton Memorial Civic Center.
Well, they are certainly a franchise in transition. There's been a lot of rumors over the past couple of years about them relocating to a larger city, a bigger venue, and that's a tough thing to play with day in and day out, and certainly wholesale changes, not seeing the kind of success they had when they dominated this league in the early years.
Yeah, they won actually 5 championships, 4+ tournament championship, the Challenge Cup in 1988, so 5 titles in the NPSL. They have a great goalkeeper in Jamie Swanner and some good tradition in Canton. Here's play on the far side. Provan shot blocked away and knocked in the midfield with 3.5 minutes left in the opening quarter. Cincinnati looking for their 4th win at home and looking for their 1st point of the night. And they drop it back for Provan on the right side for Blakeman. Blakeman drops it for Provan in the midfield. Provan, a third-year NPSL player, acquired for Chris Fowle, who's now in Canton, although not playing tonight. Play up the left side and controlled by Carrera, who bangs it off the boards into Cincinnati territory.
Steve Provan's younger brother was on the Wisconsin team that won the NCAA Division I Men's Championship back in early December. Certainly a quality thing there. Blakeman not obviously happy at all about the situation at the moment, but Cincinnati simply got to regroup defensively.
Boy, Blakeman is fired up. Dwight not happy about this Cincinnati barrage against them here in the first quarter of play. He's a real mean-looking guy. And the ball on the left side, Ledesma, then a player knocked down for Cincinnati. And this will be a foul against Canton.
Yeah, we're going to get a look at it right here. The blue card came out. It's going to be a 2-minute against the team player coach, Denzel Antonio. Alcala with possession, trying to push forward. No doubt about it. Initial contact was to the body. And actually, Antonio got a bad break as then Alcala was sandwiched into the boards. Might have gotten away otherwise with a simple tripping foul. Instead, we get the penal call. It'll be a 2-minute penalty, a shootout for Sean Medved, and then a Silverback power play. Another thing we want to point out about this 6-point advantage for Canton, this is the largest lead they've had all season.
9:04, a hold. You get a chance for 2 points. One in the shootout, and then you get a power play for 2 minutes for the 2nd bonus point. And the leading scorer, Medved, will go to try and nail it home for the 1st goal. Medved in, shoots it, and he couldn't get the opportunity on the 2nd shot. You get 5 seconds to nail it home, Dwight. if you miss it, it's not like hockey on a penalty shot where once you miss it, you have to stop. You get 5 seconds here, and he misfired on the second opportunity off the backboard.
Up until last weekend, he was leading the league in converting those. He is now 7 of 11. That's his patented move. Played it in the boards. Why did the keeper get his own rebound? But the Amico obviously had gone to school because he was waiting for it.
Cincinnati 8th in the league in power plays, and Canton a pretty good penalty killing unit. As you can tell, the play for Beck now drops it back for Blakeman. Cincinnati on their first power play. They look for their first point of the night. They can only get one here, however. Here's Beck, back to the right wing side. Nedved now plays it into the corner. Provan shoots, he scores! Steve Provan lights it up at 6-1.
Outstanding patience in and around the box. Cincinnati got the ball, moved it some more. Eventually, it goes down into the corner. Medved, the team's leading point producer, sets up Provan, and he roofs it. The Amico went down a bit too soon, goes right over top of his head into the bottom of the netting, and finally, the Silverbacks are on the board.
Steve Provan acquired from this team. He's thrilled about it. It's a new breath of life for him, and he nails it against his former team.
Certainly like to see Steve Provan have a big night because on the one hand, he knows more of these Canton Invader players than anybody else. At the same time, there's been a lot of changes in the lineup since he came to the Queen City.
And here's Carlos Pena, who looks for his third win of the year, eighth year in the NPSL. Plays it for Canton in a midfield. Hangs it off the boards for Jimmy Glenn. Moving free, Glenn turned around, tries to make a play and blocked off at the defense. Provan scores it for Cincinnati. Medved on the assist and a 6-1 score, and now a stop in the midfield.
Cincinnati caught numbers down, but it took a foul by Canton to get the break, and referee Walt Jones right on the spot to make the call.
By the way, Provan is 7th of the year from Medved. Again, that a power play goal into the opening quarter at 12-27. Cincinnati 1-for-1 with the man advantage, and will have an opportunity here. Cincinnati looking for their 4th home win. As mentioned earlier, they've really been in a lot of games. In fact, they've lost 7 at home, and 4 of those 7 games have been decided by 4 or fewer points. So they've been really in all their games here at home. Here's Beck, shoots high off the top of the glass and then cleared, but not out. Cincinnati battling along the boards for the player on the far side. Alcala shoots, blocked away at the defense, and I believe it was Scott who played goal to save it.
Brilliant effort by Sean Medved to weave his way through all sorts of trouble. The pass was perhaps a half stride behind Alcala. He hung tough, but good rotation on the defense by Canton to keep the ball out of the net.
And now it's Antonio, their coach, who also, of course, plays on the backfield for Canton and then cleared for Cincinnati. Alcala on the right side just bangs it all the way down. But just over a minute to go in the opening quarter of play. And D'Amico, in his 14th game of the year, has only 4 wins in 3 years for this Canton team. 4-27 is record, and now in the midfield, a stop play, and then earlier play to give Canton that setup to the right side. Gary Hindley is not happy about it.
Well, with some reason, too. It was a real sluggish start by Cincinnati, although they're starting to show some new signs of life.
Here's the play now to the left of the goal with 43 seconds to go in the quarter. Cincinnati trying to bang into the boards, and a stop and a foul against Canton. And as a result, Cincinnati will have a late break here in the first quarter to get a couple of points back out of their own side of the field. And it's a long clearing attempt on the right side and a break for Cincinnati. On the right side, Thomas, and a stop and a play back the other side for Canton.
Yeah, tough break for Mark Thomas. He did well to get himself free. The ball came up hard off the turf, caught him in the right wing, and that was that.
Here's play up the left side and now all the way back into the Cincinnati end. So once more, they'll have a chance to set up with 20 seconds to go in the opening quarter of play, and Pena will be the guy to lead the attack.
Well, Carlos is going to be real pleased to see this first quarter expire. It's been a nightmare.
Cincinnati down by 5. They have a late chance here. 8 seconds to go. The centering pass off the mark is Ledesma, who set up Hesch for the first goal. Able to play it into midfield, and that's going to do it. The buzzer sound signaling the end of the first quarter. The Silverbacks, who have had some tough times in 95-96, down 6-1 after a one-quarter play. When we come back, the second period, Silverbacks down by 5 against the Ohio Canton Invaders. Cincinnati Silverback Soccer is sponsored in part by Soccer Village, official supplier to the Silverbacks. We're at the Cincinnati Gardens tonight. The Cincinnati Silverbacks in their initial season taking on the Canton Invaders here tonight. I'm Mike Barak alongside Dwight Burgess. Glad you've joined us this evening. Cincinnati down by 5, although the shots on goal probably biggest stat there, Dwight, and pretty much even.
Yeah, really up and down the column there, it's fairly level. The key has been Canton taking advantage of the opportunities that present themselves.
Early on, Canton scored a goal at 33 seconds into the opening quarter, and then it's been downhill for Cincinnati from there. Carrera and Scott nailing 2-point goals. The only goal for Cincinnati at the end of period one, and Provan on that power play goal to cut it to 6-1.
And a well-crafted score it was. Too bad we couldn't connect on the shootout.
Okay, here we go up the left side. Cincinnati coming into the action in fifth place in the American Division of the National Professional Soccer League. Canton in last place at 3-17. Cincinnati, however, down by 5 in the first quarter of play. And Sean Blakeman, the former Wichita wing, in for the forward Thomas, back to Blakeman at the yellow line. Cincinnati starting off in possession. The veteran Fernandez, who played for Gary Hindley in Cleveland, plays it free to Blakeman, shoots in a left footer way upstairs. He got a lot of mustard on it, but he misfires up into the stands.
Well, Blakeman and Beck in particular have some real success this season coming out of the defensive half and hitting the bombs from distance, but on that occasion more of a technique problem than anything. His foot was behind the ball in contact. That gives you your flight.
We're here at the Cincinnati Gardens. This is year one. Expansion franchise for the Cincinnati Silverbacks. The Canton Invaders, a charter member of the NPSL, and now paying it back into midfield. And after this season, they'll be the only pro sports team in that city, Dwight. They're losing their minor league baseball team, so right now Canton left with the Invaders in that city. With a minute gone, second quarter, and Pena, who ranked sixth in the league in PAA, drops it back. He had 20 victories in 1992-93. Leaves it free into the corner, and the Silverbacks trying to get back into this thing. And Medved at the arc drops for Blakeman. Centers for Terry Brown. back for Medved. It's the Silverbacks. Medved trying to jam it free. Stops, drops it back for Blakeman. Cincinnati on the perimeter, looking to make an offensive play quickly.
Yeah, trying to draw Canton out defensively. You've got Glenn and Brown rotating around the box.
And now Blakeman backpedals for Cincinnati. On the left side is the Silverbacks, trying to muscle up something, and D'Amico leaves it on the left side. Cincinnati steal, however, to the near side. Medved dropped for Canton. Shoots, he scores! Jimmy Canton with a rocket down. Scott Canton down the left side. And with 13:09 left in the second, it's a 6-3 game. He let go a bullet into the Canton end.
It all started with D'Amico. He got the ball, turned it over. Cincinnati countered. Excellent technique. He puts it home. Medved got it after the turnover. Sets up perfectly in stride. Canton with the left wicket inside the far post. Nice stuff.
And for Scott Canton, a scoring play for Cincinnati. And a minute 54 gone into the second quarter of play.
Well, D'Amico not known for being real strong with his feet, trying to play balls out of the back. It got pressure that time from Glenn. D'Amico turned it over, went to Medved. A touch later, it's a 6-3 score.
Medved on the assist, Canton seventh, and that is mentioned, cutting it to 6-3. Canton, who hails from Evansville, as mentioned earlier, his family watching, coming to a majority of the games this year, but sitting back in Evansville and watching tonight. Played at the University of Evansville 3 seasons ago in Harrisburg. Last season, 10 games in Detroit. And now Canton, who have given up the last three, have possession in the midfield.
Well, a bit more on purpose to the collective Silverback step here in the early minutes of quarter two, and it's paying some dividends.
Here's Vincent Beck ahead on the right side, trying to move it free, blocked away, and then Provan moving in. A centering pass off the mark, and the Silverbacks now have the momentum.
Once again, pressure to D'Amico. He turns the ball over.
Here's Canton again, tied up on a tackle to the left side, and then up to Carrera, their leading scorer. Up the right side on a two-man break now, across the line, the chip pass off the mark as it was intended. From Defini off the left wing side for Scott. And Cincinnati's Pena waits, fakes a hurl, and then will kick it up the left side.
Solid man down defending by Beck. He got between the two red jerseys and then was patient, waited for help to come. Canton on full flight was getting back, and Beck got the ball.
Here's a lead pass up the left side, blocked away into midfield. And Blakeman beautifully chips it back on the left wing side. And Fernandez skies it free. Blakeman elects to use his leg to block it away, and then Cincinnati on the attack. This is the first season of the Cincinnati Silverbacks, and Terry Brown leaves it free up the left side, blocked away and cleared into midfield. And then Glenn has possession, beautifully drops it back for Blakeman up the left side. Cincinnati looking to cut the lead to one. Blakeman moving in, and then he's knocked off the ball. I believe a foul. Let's see. On the left side, Paul Kahn, I believe, is the guilty Canton Invader.
Well, Blakeman drew him in tightly, then made the cut from right to left. Wanted to go from distance, but Kahn did all he could. That's get in the way and draw the obstruction call.
And it was Blakeman who started that play. And as a result, Cincinnati will start it up. Here's a play up the right side. Blakeman shoots it with his left foot, bangs it upstairs, way up to the right of the goal. And he's getting the good distance on it now. He needs the accuracy towards that net.
Well, it looked like he was a bit unlucky that time. The ball hopped up just as he got ready to strike through. Much more conservative was he in that effort. Got into good position, came through softly, much more like you'll see in a golf swing. It's timing.
This guy, the goalkeeper, D'Amico, ties his shoes around two or three times so he doesn't lose that footwear.
With the problems he's having distributing with his boots, perhaps it'd be better to find a new way to tie the strings.
Yeah, this is a guy that's 4-27 over the last 3 years. Hasn't had at times a lot in front of him, then hurls it just underneath. Did it hit the scoreboard? It did. He was hurling it down. He misfires, and as a result, Cincinnati will take possession deep into Canton territory. A misplay for him, so instead of using his feet, he used his arm, and it hurt him.
Can't help think about D'Amico, 4-27, if you're a Major League Baseball pitching free agent.
Here's a play, they score! It was Medved on a three-point blast, and if they counted a three, we're in a six-all tie.
Just an outstanding clean strike from John Medved. Just to finish the thought, I was going to say, D'Amico still on the goal at 4:27. Stepped right up, almost no wall at all. There are a couple of red shirts standing there, but they didn't block any angle. Right up to it, next to the ball, followed through, and drove it past and up into the net. Great strike from Medved.
His 24th total goal of the year, his third three-pointer of 95-96, and we're in a tie game here in Cincinnati after a 6-1 outburst for Canton. The Silverbacks, with three in a row, have tied the game. And another misplay by D'Amico for the second straight time. He bangs it off the scoreboard here in Cincinnati.
More than anything else, Mike, I would say here in the second quarter, it has really been Cincinnati winning now the 50-50s. They were losing them more often than not in the first 15 minutes.
Medved, a 5-point net already, plays it to the left of the goal. And Steridisot, a 3-point goal, and two helpers are ready for the Silverbacks. At an unassisted goal, his 3-point effort. Here's Provan now. His shot blocked away as there were two red shirts in the vicinity. And it's cleared for Canton up the left side with 10:24 left in the second. And this is the way it was against Cincinnati in the first few minutes of play. Now it's all Silverbacks here in the second quarter. And Vincent Beck rims it off the dashers towards the net and caught by D'Amico. And he, this time, rolls it so he doesn't hit the scoreboard.
It's an excellent point. What Cincinnati's doing when he gets the ball is they're backing off quickly, inviting him to lay it down rather than quickly throwing if they had put big pressure on.
Now up the left side, Alcala now for Cincinnati. Winds it free on the far side as the Silverbacks wheel it free for Medved, just outside the yellow line. In, gets away from the defense, now lets it fly, and blocked off for the last moment by Paul Kahn. Otherwise, the Silverbacks had a chance to take the lead. And of course, in this sport, they make the fans, or in this case, the crew members, throw it up back onto the field. Here's a shot going off the backboards and wide. Can't keep them as souvenirs, Dwight.
You want the league to go bankrupt?
And Alcala will drop it back, and we'll have a restart here with 9:39 left in the second quarter. I've seen shots go off into the stands and up towards the runway, and late in the game, you'll see people take the ball and run out of the building with them as they clear it free into the corner, and the Silverbacks take possession. A 6-all tie here in the middle period. We're at two Ohio teams battling it out. Former Dayton Dynamo, the Cincinnati Silverbacks, and the Canton Invaders. And Terry Brown, boy, he's hit hard right in front of Gary Hindley's players, and it was Carrera, their leading scorer, that gave them the bump right in front of the Cincinnati bench.
Cincinnati averaging 11 points a game this season, even dozen for the visitors, and it would seem to this point that the clubs are on their way to breaking that average.
And it's cleared by Cincinnati up towards the stands once more with 9:03 left in the second. A youngster holds on, and he tosses it back into the field. Well, you mentioned the point situation. Canton, a whopping 357 points against. That ranks them last in defense, so we're seeing if the Cincinnati Silverbacks can take advantage of that.
Statistically, there are some similarities between the two teams, but that's the biggest difference, points allowed.
Here's a shot right on, and the save made by Pena. Spectacular save on the player cutting in front, Paul Kahn, for the Canton Invaders. Now a pass again, blocked away and headed up the right side, and the Silverbacks, Medved, can't clear the zone, and finally it's taken by Terry Brown up the left side. The St. Louis native knocked down by Kevin Scott. A foul, and Cincinnati will restart into midfield. 8.5 minutes left in the second. Cincinnati, with five consecutive points, have tied the game.
Absolutely brilliant save by Carlos Pena as he climbs the ladder to get up to the right side. Great strike from short range, but Carlos up there knocks it away. He, of course, an all-star last season, and in his initial campaign made the NPSL all-rookie team.
Last year, unfortunately, did not play in the game, although named to the all-star team, and dropped back for Pena himself.
You know, another note about Carlos Pena, he was invited to the MLS Combine Camp in Los Angeles this week, but stepped aside when Mark Simpson, the backup netminder, went down with surgery. Pena didn't want to risk injury trying out for the summer league. He stayed home.
And it's a league that's gaining a lot of notoriety right now. A number of players in the league gaining opportunities to play in that new summer league, and we'll have a stop and a restart this time for Canton as the Silverbacks will have that wall right to the top of the arc, and they do a nice job to block it away.
Yeah, put Ledesma to the ball this time instead of Carrera.
And here's Ledesma again, right wing side pass, a shot going over top and into the corner. It bounces around, Cincinnati trying to make a play, loose to the top of the box. Ledesma tied up beautifully, and Thomas now knocked off the ball by Antonio, and a scramble and a break for the Silverbacks as Antonio got the last shot in there. Thus, Cincinnati will take over.
And as Thomas moves off the field, he's got a bit of a limp in his step. We'll keep an eye on that. Antonio, of course, sent off to the bad boys bin in quarter number one. Another big hit from him. No card on this occasion.
Nedved, by the way, already with 5 points. His fifth consecutive multiple point game for Cincinnati. Started the action with 62 points, now has 67 on the year, thanks to his great first half against Canton. And it is now Pena banks it with his right foot all the way down. Ahead to the right side. Goalkeepers are such an integral part of the offense as Pena able to wing it right down, and a player shaken up for Cincinnati, and it was Glenn. Thus, Cincinnati will take over deep into the Canton end.
Canton is vulnerable on the restarts. They gave up 6 restart goals in one game, a league record to St. Louis just a week ago.
Blakeman will start it up for the Cincinnati Silverbacks. He's had a number of good scoring chances himself early on, and now will try and set it up, does to Medved, shoots it, a right-footed blast up into the stands. He was set up where he wanted to and then just misfires high.
Yeah, needs to think back to what he did on the 3-point goal he had a few minutes ago. That's technique. He planted his foot, but at contact basically held up. That put the ball up in the air. Wants to come right through and land on the shooting foot.
Chris D'Amico leaves it for his own defense. D'Amico, a 24-year-old, able to clear it up the left side and wound free into midfield. Silverbacks, Peggy trying to jam it loose. It's cleared up the right side for the player on the right wing side. Hesh's shot going wide. Now Masavent has possession. An Iranian, second Iranian to play in this league, moves in, tries to play it free in front, blocked away, headed by Blake. Another shot going over top of the net by Ledesma, and then Pena controls. The shot actually went over the crossbar, off the glass, and back towards Pena net.
Yeah, and good composure from Proven. He came in, got to the rebound, played it right to Carlos, and out we go.
Silverbacks now work it for Glenn up the left side. Jimmy Glenn now out of Clemson University, shoots and blocked aside at the defense rebound. Glenn, another chance. This time, D'Amico steers it aside. Glenn now closing in for Cincinnati. Holding on, centers in front. Proven, a shot blocked away. And the Silverbacks holding on with the momentum. Blakeman into midfield, chips it free, broken up. And it's on the right side now. Antonio, their player coach, a pass to Ledesma in. Shoots him off the backboards and wide. Rebound controlled. Swanson a shot. Oh, and Pena gets an arm on that rebound and cleared away. And that's what's happened this season. Pena's been there to keep the points against down.
The last couple of years, the Dayton Dynamo struggled, but Carlos Pena still got the recognition of his peers, made it into the All-Star game despite playing for a team that had numbers much more similar to this current Canton squad.
88-89, rookie of the year in this league. Here's a shot caught by Pena again, this one from long range from Carrera, and he is on fire. And now they're going to call a timeout here with 5:09 left in the second quarter. Cincinnati at 1 point down 6-0. They scored 1 on a power play late in the first, and then have scored 5 here in the second quarter of play, and thanks to Pena. And you take a look, Pena in the leader, 6th in the league, and yet his record 2-12, but a scintillating 13.4 points against average.
He's recognized not only in the NPSL, but being one of the handful of goalkeepers nationwide invited to the aforementioned MLS Combine. What that was is about 250 players that were hand-selected nationally to come together for a week in Los Angeles. And from that pool, they are going to outfit the 10 MLS teams that kick off in April. MLS, or Major League Soccer, is designed to be the premier outdoor league, and actually a very cooperative effort between this, the premier indoor league, and that.
Of course, when you come down to the Cincinnati Gardens, it's more than just a soccer game. You can pick up your Silverbacks merchandise, and that's what's happening. Youngsters thrilled about it. What a family sport this is, Dwight. Great venue here in Cincinnati at the Cincinnati Gardens. The fans are right on top of the action. And for as quick as this game, what a great place to watch an indoor soccer game.
Well, no doubt about it. You look up and down the rows of seats and you see all the youngsters that are here. You've got the games at halftime, lots of activities. And you mentioned the families. There's a big family pack deal going on right now. They can call the Silverbacks office for more details on that.
4-5-8 kick, $39 for the game against Tampa Bay on January 19th. That's next Friday night, as the Tampa Bay Terror and the Cincinnati Silverbacks. 15-10, shots on goal. Silverbacks were outshot early and now have taken the lead in this department.
Coming into the game tonight, Cincinnati was second in the league in shots allowed per game.
8-4 in this quarter in favor of the Silverbacks as well, and wound up the left side and cleared, headed by Terry Brown. In, oh, he's leveled by Kevin Scott, and we'll see if there's just going to be a foul or a penalty. Looks just like the restart, and Cincinnati will take over deep into the zone.
Well, looked like Terry Brown forced the contact a bit by getting up in the air, but it worked.
Here's Thomas tries to chip it free off the start. Great pass across to the near side for Cannon, as the Silverbacks trying to work it for Brown. Up the left side for Medved, who scored that to three-pointer to tie the game. Medved across for Cannon. He scored one, shoots with his right foot this time and bangs it upstairs with 4.5 minutes left in the second quarter. A youngster tossing it back in, and Silverbacks all over. Damico in goal, as Baxter, the Silverback mascot, is thrilled about it as well.
I think Sean Medved would like another crack at that restart. The ball was played across to him. He laid it off to Cannon, anticipating more pressure than he actually got.
Here's play up the left side, and Brown leaves it back for Pena for Cincinnati. 28 years of age. He's from Los Angeles and will set it up for his own defense with 4:12 left in the second quarter of play. Here's a pass ahead for Thomas, intended for him. Cincinnati trying to work it for Cannon and blocked up the left side. And Terry Brown able to cover up into midfield. Cincinnati have scored 6 in a row to tie the game. Drop pass off the mark. Carrera steals on the right wing side. And the Canton Invaders, and Bryans drops it back for his own defense.
Bryans, a youngster, a little guy too, just 5'8", 165. That's on a good day, and seeing his first rotation of this Friday evening.
Ben Powers now in his fourth season with Canton, tries to work it free, and Pena steers it aside.
Now Bryans may be small in stature, but he cracked one there.
And now Cincinnati's Fernandez, the veteran who played with the Cleveland Crunch, ahead on the right side for Thomas, and then out to play at Damico, and he hurls it with his right arm up the right side. Behind the back, however, of the player on the right side, Kahn, and cleared into midfield where the Bermuda native, Kahn, leaves it free on the left side. Hesch, who scored the first goal, fires off the backboards and wide, headed by Beck, up the left side, Provan trying to chip it out, and held in by the Canton Invaders. On the right side, Swanson shoots right through the goal crease, and nobody home. And then Terry Brown leveled again, this time by Carrera. Are we going to have a penalty? Brown was just smacked again, right to the near side.
Now that's the kind of thing we saw out of Terry Brown when he worked his way through a pair of 15-day contracts earlier in the season. Good position up against the boards, and as you can see, coming in hard and contact into the center of his back, no doubt about it. That is indeed a 2-minute penal penalty. Cincinnati will get another shootout.
And the penalty, again, Carrera, and a shootout for Cincinnati, and an opportunity here with 2:52 remaining in the quarter. It is a boarding penalty. The time here, 12:08, and a chance to take the lead. And who else with 5 points already in this game? Medved will go for Cincinnati. This is for the bonus point, the 1-point shootout goal. He has 5 seconds to work. Shoots, he scores!
No fooling around on this occasion. Medved said, forget the boards. One touch, Damico comes out, and a rocket right past him. You can see the ball was almost into the goal by the time Damico could even get the left hand up. Medved converts.
A 6-point effort for him, a 3-pointer, 2 assists, and now his 25th goal of the year, his second of the game. And the Silverbacks penalty killing is up there. Canton second in the league. Here's a play to the near side as the player Thomas shot blocked off. So although Canton has struggled, they've been good. A man short. Here's Medved off the left side as the Silverbacks try and convert. They scored on the shootout. Have a chance for one more point here as Glenn leaves it back to the point for Blakeman. Shoots! He just misses. Medved at the yellow line as Blakeman recovers on the far side. Chips it free for Beck in centers, blocked away, and Medved takes over for Cincinnati.
Well, Cincinnati, Mike, definitely going back to what worked the first time around. That's patience on the perimeter, a hit from distance, look for the loose ball and the opportunity to finish.
Here's Medved on the left side for Blakeman. Lead pass ahead on the far wing. Here's the centering pass in front. Oh, and the pass across to the left wing side, off the mark. And clear to the right side where Medved leaves for Blakeman. It was Thomas on that setup in front for Beck. Now back to Blakeman. Closing in. Right side for Medved. Shoots. Blocked away. Rebound in front. Thomas couldn't get his leg on it. And chip back for Medved. 50 seconds left in the penalty. 1:40 to go in the quarter. 7-6 Cincinnati. 7 consecutive points. Here's the play off the backboards in front for Thomas. And cleared but not out. Blakeman for the moment keeps it in, then he muffs it, gets back up on his knees, trying to jam it loose, and Cincinnati continuing to control.
It's been a pretty good power play, Cincinnati getting the opportunities they want.
Here's Thomas, a centering pass off the arm of D'Amico and cleared, but not out. Blakeman now for Cincinnati, 20 seconds to go on the penalty for Medved. Closing in, centers across, Thomas back to the left wing side, Blakeman! Oh, and it's blocked off by Antonio. Great setup for Blakeman.
Good strike from Blakeman indeed. Antonio stood him up.
And now Cincinnati on the attack again. Medved across to Blakeman. In centers. Off the mark. Here's Medved. Fires. That's why. That's into the penalty. Cincinnati now can get 2 points as the pass for Fernandez moving free.
Little arcade style tactic there. Just line up the ducks and have a go.
And Fernandez now will set it up out of Cal State Hayward. Trying to maneuver free. Clear, however, knocked off the ball and cleared right back down. 27 seconds to go. 7-6 Cincinnati. And a break again for Alcala. Left side pass across and a break for Cincinnati. Quick shot towards the net. Locked away as Fernandez let it fly. 15 seconds to go in the quarter and can right now. They're the team that wants to get out of here. Only minus 1 point and cleared for Carrera up the right side. 5 seconds to go in the quarter. Not much time for him. A pass in front for the player on the right side, Scott, and that does it. A Cincinnati comeback, 7 in a row to take the lead.
Good quality second quarter, Mike. It was a sluggish first 15 minutes. Cincinnati stepped it up, challenged for the 50-50s, created some opportunities, and more importantly, finishing them off. Gary Hindley's going to go to the locker room, I think, feeling a bit better about the initial 30 minutes tonight.
Okay, it's a 7-6 Cincinnati lead. We'll come back with more. This is Cincinnati Silverback Soccer on Sports Channel.
Transport.
Yes, I can. Welcome back, everybody, to the score here. 7-6 Cincinnati over the Canton Invaders at the end of two quarters of play. Gentleman here that is well known about goalkeeping here in the National Professional Soccer League. Unfortunately, Mark Simpson, who was born here in Cincinnati, out of the lineup. And Mark, your impression so far of the first half?
Well, I thought we started out a bit slow, and after a while, you know, we just get the competitive juices flowing again and, you know, start to put some pressure on their goal, and I think that's the type of game we need to play tonight.
Well, you're an expert on goalkeeping, and I'll tell you what, Carlos Pena, after the first six goals, really came to life, made some huge stops, and then the Silverbacks came back and have taken the lead.
Yeah, I know Carlos and I are really tight, so I don't mean to sound real cocky or anything, but I know it bothers him not being there with him. And I knew he was a little mentally down tonight. And, you know, it was a good thing for him to get a couple of quality saves in, and that way to pick his game up to where we know that the lowest man can play.
Tell us about your injury. What's the situation?
I had a meniscus tear. I did it last Friday in the pregame against Cleveland. And I tried to rehab it for a couple of days. It just kept getting worse, and just decided to have surgery. I figure the sooner I get in, the quicker I get back.
All right, and of course, getting an opportunity here, your seventh year in the National Professional Soccer League, and the Silverbacks, an expansion team. What can you tell us about this team? And I know the trials and tribulations in year one here in Cincinnati.
Well, I think you have to look at the whole organization, including the Cyclones. It's such a professional atmosphere. It's the most professional team that I've ever been on. They make you feel like, you know, you're a pro. I love to come to work every day, and that's what it should be all about. And with the Cyclones being so successful, you know, it's going to take some time getting the people, the personnel that we need to have on the field. And I think you'll see a growing sport here in Cincinnati.
Final note, you were born here in Cincinnati, but I understand not here a long time as a youngster.
Right. I lived here till I was 10, grew up in the Loveland area, started playing before I left, went up to Chicago for 18 years. And, you know, a big reason for me getting back here, my dad still lives here, and it was very important for me to try to get back home, and I'm very comfortable here. That's why I like it.
All right, a Cincinnati native, Mark, best of luck to you and the Silverbacks the rest of the way.
Thank you very much.
This has been the Soccer Village Intermission Interview. The score, 7-6 in favor of the Cincinnati Silverbacks over the Canton Invaders. Hope you enjoyed Mark Simpson. We'll come back with more in just a moment on Sports Channel.
Welcome back, everybody, to the Gardens, where it's halftime between Cincinnati and Canton. And here at the break, I'm joined by the leading scorer of the Silverbacks, Sean Medved. And Sean, first of all, how's the season been going for you? You've got to feel good about the points.
Well, yeah, I feel good about the points, but that's not really the main issue. The main issue is getting more wins in the win bracket. And as many close games as we've been in, we've had too many losses at this point. We're our goal, of course, is to make the playoffs. And right now, we're in a bit of a hole, and we were going to have to get on a little streak here to to get it back towards 500, where I think is the point where we'll make the playoffs.
Has one of the biggest challenges for you thus far this season been the mental aspect, considering the last time you played in this league, you won a championship in Cleveland, and specifically these close games that are going against the Silverbacks right now?
Well, yeah, absolutely. I mean, in Cleveland, we had, you know, they're still a great team. We were a great team then, and, you know, we had an attitude that every game we're going to win, you know, and someone else is going to have to come out there and beat us. And here with a new team, that attitude is, you know, it's hard to find. It's hard to get. And when the close games are on the line, you know, we're not quite there being able to put a team away when we should. And in Cleveland, you know, there's three or four of us from Cleveland here, and we, you know, I think we have that attitude, but it's difficult to get that, you know, for the whole team and be able to win those games.
Six losses already this season by 1 or 2 points. Anything particular theme coming through to you at this point in the season about why those close losses like that?
Well, that's a tough question. It goes the same thing. I think that, you know, when the game is on the line, some of the teams that we're playing and losing close games to are those teams that have an attitude, which is we are going to win, you know, and so we'll find a way somehow or another. And we've had a little taste of that where we've had some close games that we did pull out. And, you know, it's just going to take time. I think at this point, you know, we're almost to the halfway point. I think we, you know, right now we need to understand what that is and be able to put those games away, the close ones especially.
How much added pressure, if any, really, do you feel yourself, Mark Thomas, George Fernandez, guys out of that championship crunch team? You have to come in and take a leadership role.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that's one of the reasons, you know, Gary brought us in here. We have a lot of, you know, different players, a lot of players that do have experience and leadership, but it's putting them together and, you know, the characters and the lines and getting everything tight. From Cleveland and the leadership role, I think that, you know, Mark, myself, and George have taken that. You know, George has been out quite a bit, but I would call him our number one leader. You know, he's our captain. He's been around the most. He's, you know, been a coach. And, you know, we look to him for a lot of things. And when he's not on the field, you know, that's going to hurt, especially in the defensive sector.
This has been a busy week, one of eight players on the Silverback squad to be invited out to the MLS Combine in Los Angeles. Now, you have already signed a contract with the league, but still don't know where you're going to be playing. What was it like out there?
Well, it was interesting. It was something I've never done. You had, you know, a lot of players from this league and players from around the country. He had a number of players that were already under contract that were there just so some of the coaches could get a better look at you and how you play. And then you had a lot of players out there who were trying to get a job that don't have contracts. It's hard because you're not fit for outdoor. It's a whole different fitness level than the indoor where you're used to the short, sharp fitness level. And then with the long-term running that it takes in outdoor was difficult, you know, and it was a little tiring. But, you know, we had the day off yesterday to travel and get back and, you know, you feel good now. So,
how do you think the tryouts went for you and the other guys from the Silverbacks?
I think everybody did good. The Npsl players that were out there, the word around, you know, the combine was that the Npsl players were the most, you know, impressive to the coaches and the other players that were there. And that's good for this league. It's great because you've got a lot of guys who played professionally. Yeah, it's indoor, and some of the guys haven't played outdoor for quite a while, but you can tell that the level of professionalism and skill and just overall knowledge of soccer is better.
Sean, good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you.
Stay with us. We've got the second half coming up as Silverback Soccer continues right here on Sports Channel.
What you said at the outset. I heard the highlights and then the dial summary. What was first? Okay. Beautiful. Okay. Cincinnati Gardens. tonight. The Cincinnati Silverbacks are erasing a 6-0 deficit and have the lead 7-6. Mike Barrack alongside Dwight Burgess. What a comeback for the Cincinnati Silverbacks in their first year.
Really a tale of two cities, so to speak, in the first two quarters. The initial 15 minutes, Canton had the better of the play. They were challenging and winning the 50-50s. Silverbacks turned the tables in the second 15 minutes, and it's paid off.
Well, look, not too good for Cincinnati at the outset, but the Silverbacks coming back, but early on it was all Canton.
Yeah, Canton got on the board right away. It took just 33 seconds. Hesch is ultimately going to finish it. Antonio with the center. Ledesma, a great pass, the controlling touch. Blakeman just gave too much space inside the box. Really nothing Carlos Pena can do.
Next one was a bad mistake. Fernandez had position. It was poked away. Carrera went 1v1, used the boards, give and go to himself. That was that. The Invaders then pushed up by an even half dozen. Scott from Defini is the way it's going to finish off. Again, just too much space. This time, it was Provan who gave up inside position, and Canton took advantage of the opportunity. Silverbacks counter. Great stuff around the perimeter. It's going to be a one-point power play goal as Provan went top shelf to get it up and over D'Amico to put the Silverbacks on the board. Then trailing by five, Cannon set up by Medved. Brilliant strike with the left. It was put right on stride as he ran to goal and slotted it home. Suddenly, Cincinnati made it a game just down three. Here's the backbreaker. Restart goal. The wall, you can clearly see, is out of position. Went right through the hands of D'Amico. Just struck too hard for him to do anything about. And then finally, Sean Medved finishes off half number one. This time, not fooling around on the shootout. Went straight to goal and knocked it home.
Well, for Medved, what a great quarter. And a half, 6 out of a possible 7 points for him for the Silverbacks. We take a look at our dial scoring summary, and early on it was all Canton, but as mentioned, the Silverbacks coming back.
Really, 3 goals in the first 8 minutes, but finally, it was really that Provan power play tally that got things turned around.
Yeah, the Silverbacks gaining the momentum, and then, of course, with that big 7-point display here in the second quarter of play. Well, the Silverbacks, after down early, have come back, and it should be a great second half here. 7-6 Cincinnati after 2 quarters of play. We'll come back with more in just a moment on Sports Channel. How do we go there? Everything cool, David? Okay, great. Great. I love this live shit, you know? Man, if you screw up here, that's it.
Dwight, if you get a chance, can I get your autograph out?